light wants to.
Bye.
in St. Charlie.
St. Charlie.
St. Charlie.
Wings of a dove.
We don't like to clap our hands.
Children. St. Charlie.
And so if it looks like that we don't know what we're doing, that's totally wrong because we practice a lot. So let's do, she's my truck driving queen. We are never doing any bluegrass, but this has got a little element to the bluegrass.
G, you want it, G or D?
G. From Carolina to Alabama, all down that Georgia line. I got
that we think God doesn't answer in time, that he puts us off and we have to wait a lot of times to get an answer. But you know, God is working all the time. It's just that we don't see that far ahead. And this is what happened with Gideon. You know, God called him to save their nation. And he called him a mighty man of God. And naturally, Gideon, he thought, me? Who are you talking about? I'm not any mighty man of God. I'm hiding from the Midianites and trying to save my life. And so, you know, God was calling him before they needed him. Because it wasn't very long until the Midianites and Ammonites were going to attack their country. And had they not had a leader and an army together, it would have overrun them and killed them out, a lot of them. So God was working ahead of time, but Gideon wasn't aware of this. And you remember the last time that I told the story, Gideon had been told to make a sacrifice to God and to tear down the altars to Baal and to cut down the grove, and he did this. And the people in the city, the men of the city, came and said, who did this? We want to know, because we're going to kill him. Whoever it was that did this, we're going to kill him because he cut down our altar. Well, someone told them that it was Gideon. And Gideon was a son of Joash. You got back just in time for the story.
Amen.
So Joash said, are you going to ask me to protect Baal? You want me to bring out my son to give to you to kill because of Baal? He said, let Baal plead for himself if he's a god. So Gideon's father stood up for him, which was wonderful that he stood there and would not let them take his son to kill him because he had torn down the altars. Makes me think that Joash really knew that they weren't supposed to be serving these idol gods, even though it was on Joash's land and a little hilltop there. He knew that he was doing the wrong thing. And you know, that's usually the way it is with us. We know when we're doing the wrong thing, and sometimes we get in trouble for it, and we have to repent. So Gideon survived that. They didn't get him and take him and kill him. And in the meantime, while this was going on, there were armies that were gathering together to come against their country. And this army came down in the valley of Jezreel. Just people, men, soldiers, just as far as you can see, a great number of people came against them. And Gideon found out that they were down there, and he thought, oh my, what am I going to do? So what he did, he prayed. He said, Lord, if this is really you that's telling me that I'm supposed to go fight against this army, I need a sign. So he took a part of the fleece of a sheep, cut out a piece of it, laid it out on the ground or a board or something, and he said, now Lord, don't get angry with me, but I really do need a sign. And he said, in the morning, if this is wet, this piece of fleece is wet, and all of the rest of the ground around it is dry, then I'll know that it was you that did this. Now, we know that fleece has oil in the base because it's a skin, and it doesn't absorb water very well at all. The next morning, Gideon went out there and he picked up this fleece, and he had a bowl, and he wrung that fleece out and got a bowl of water. Now, that's a miracle, to get a bowl of water out of a piece of a sheep's skin. So then he said, Lord, don't get angry with me. I still need just a little bit more encouragement to make sure that that wasn't any accident last night. So he said, I'm going to put this fleece out here. And in the morning, if this fleece is dry and the ground all around it is wet, then I'll know that you didn't. It won't be just an accident. So that night he put the fleece out, and the next morning he went down there to check it. And guess what? The fleece was dry and the ground all around it was just wet with dew. He said, okay, okay, I know that's it's you. So he sent out a call to the tribes that were around there and said, come and help us. We're going to destroy these Midianites that are coming against us. So the people started coming. The men started coming. They just came by the grove and got there. And they went over on the top of the crest of the hill where they could look down in the valley and see all these people. And the Lord spoke to Gideon and said, you got too many men here. If you go to battle like this, you're going to think that your army did this. Your men are all going to say, boy, we took care of them, didn't we? He said, now you tell every one of them, anybody that's afraid to go into battle, go home. So he told them. Two-thirds of his army left. And I'm sure Gideon thought, uh-oh. And then God told him again, he said, you still got too many men. They'll still think they won this battle. So he said, you bring them down to this stream down here, to this water, and I'm going to try them there, and I'm going to pick out your army for you. So Gideon took them down there, and the Lord told him, he said, now all of these people, all these men that lap water out of their hand like a dog with their tongue, that's the one that's going to be your army. And all of them that do like I would have done, get down on your hands and knees and stick your face nearly in the water and suck up the water like that. He said, they're not going. So Gideon went down to the water, tried them that way. And after they had got a drink, there was only 300 of them left that would be the soldiers that he was to take with him. And I imagine this kind of upset Gideon maybe a little bit. If I had an army of 300 and I was looking down in that valley and seeing all those people, I would be taking some second thoughts. So that night the Lord spoke to him again and he said, Gideon, do you still have any doubts? He said, I've got something I want you to do. Take one of your men with you and go down into that valley and go down there where all those tents are, and I'm going to assure you that everything's going to be all right. So Gideon took a man with him, and they slipped down the mountainside, went down there. And as they got up close to one of these tents, he heard the men inside talking. And they were saying, I had a dream last night. One of them said, I had a dream. He said, what was it? He said, I saw this thing rolling down in our camp, and it just destroyed everything. And this other man said, that's nothing but the army of Gideon doing that. God is going to fight for them. When Gideon heard that, he nudged his friend. He said, back up the mountain. That's all I needed to hear. So back up the mountain they went to get ready to go leave for the battle. And God has further instructions for him on how that God is going to win this battle with 300. Gideon's not going to have to worry about it at all.
Do a little birthday.
Put her in G.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, God bless you. Happy birthday to you. And many more.
You're up.
If it ain't.
Once I was straight in sin's dark path, Thank you.
Maddox and Cole.
Ben.
Easy.
Ben White and Austin.
Ben. Well, I stopped in a roadhouse.
At the end of a broken dream.
said his bean cooking team was breaking up. And they've been doing cooking beans at the Bean Fest. And he asked me if I wanted to join the team, and I said, no, I'd rather sing about it. We do a song called I Got My Red Beans Cooking. It's County Blues. I got them red beans cooking.
Got them red beans cooking.
He's
got them red beans cooking.
I got them red beans cooking.
Got his red beans cooking.
I got them red beans cooking.
Got them red beans cooking.
I got them red beans cooking. Now I'm gonna eat me some. I'm going down in Louisiana. Get me a mojo hand.
Thank you. like him, hiding in a well press. And Lord, you were in control. Help us to remember when things get tough that you are still here and that you are in control. I bring our nation to you. We think of what's going on, but Lord, you're in control, and we thank you for that. Go with us. Help us, Father, to be what you would have us to be, and we'll give you the praises. Amen.
Amen.